Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for the opportunity to speak to you here. I'd like to say one thing. I agree, I believe the time is now. There is now we have a time for global change. Now it is the time where we are first time in the human history. We have these amazing great technologies. We have the internet, we have information, we can communicate. And now it's the first time ever that it is possible, at least technically it's possible, not that we are doing it, but it is possible to get rid of poverty, to be efficient, to feed people, to provide a sustainability to everybody. And now we are here discussing how to reach the goal, how to reach the best visions that are possible now. They were never possible in human history, because always in the human history, in order for somebody to live a decent, good life, somebody had to suffer, because we just didn't have the technology, we didn't have enough resources. And the important factor is indeed information, it is communication. It is important to be able to communicate, to get data. And what I would like to offer you, one of, I believe, very good tools, which gives data, which provides data, which gives information, it creates information highway for people, for companies, for schools, for cities. And this tool is, we call D21. D2.1, like a new upgrade of what? Upgrade of democracy. D can be democracy, or D can be decision-making process. So imagine an upgrade from DOS to Windows in democracy. So this is what I would like to present to you. So first, let me briefly introduce myself. I am a mathematician. I studied at Charles University, and I got my PhD at Carnegie Mellon University. And one of the second big, but big success of my life has been RSJ, a company that is a market maker, one of the largest market makers in the world on international derivative exchanges. And with the success of RSJ, which came and lasted, and already we could see that we have big resources far beyond what one could reasonably consume in his or her life. So I started to devote resources first, and then also my time to other things, social things. First, I started the Endowment for Support of Research and Science. And by I'm talking, thanks to this endowment, I also could start the Anti-Corruption Endowment. And yes, indeed, corruption is a big issue. It is like a cancer of society. And we need to fight it, and we need to do something against corruption. And this was the goal, and has been the goal, of the Anti-Corruption Endowment, which is very active here in the Czech Republic. Now, however, over some time, over actually not too long, over a year, I realized by communicating to MPs and other officials, I realized that the core of the problem of our society, and I believe it is not only Czech Republic, but it is globally a core of the problem, is the selection of leaders. Those people who are in power, those people who are leading society, they should be the masters, they should give examples. But unfortunately, it's not always the case. And indeed, it is possible to make a major improvement. And I will just show you briefly the basic idea behind D21. I will not go into details. What you will see is just a small part of it, but it should give you a picture. So imagine voting, standard voting. A city council is deciding which project to support. So we have different opportunities, including the school garden for kids, park, fireplace, etc. And then there's also VIP parking. Okay, and two guys down there, they both want VIP parking as their first choice. And with the standard voting, so-called first past the post, which is, for example, in Great United States or Great Britain, the VIP parking has two votes, so it wins. But nevertheless, this vote gives, we can argue that this kind of voting gives the worst result from the total social utility point of view. Everybody is displeased except the two guys. So what is the most important idea of democracy 2.1, the new version of democracy? It is multiple votes. more votes than the winning alternative. So if only one is to be chosen, one alternative, everybody can have two votes. So what will happen now? You can see if we have two votes, then suddenly the kindergarten wins. Nobody else gives the vote to the VIP parking anymore. And we are getting a result which is probably one of the best, if not the best, from the total social utility point of view. Not only that, democracy 2.1 has also an additional very important and useful feature, and that is so-called minus vote, a vote against. So you can vote only not for, but also against, and it is important that voting for is a larger number than against, but that's our technical details which we do not have time for. So how will the result look like now? If everybody can give also the minus vote, you can see that the VIP parking from the very first place actually goes to minus. So that's like, yeah. And this is very applicable in politics, by the way. In fact, when I designed the voting, when I designed D21, the goal was to not eliminate, but reduce corruption in the Czech Republic. It was from the anti-corruption down when I went to the voting system, and this was the goal. Now, D21 was designed for politics, to have better leaders. However, it turned out, and fortunately it is the case, that it has very wide application, not only in politics, but it has application in cities for participatory budgeting, for companies making better sustainable decisions. And this is very good, because in order to push a much better algorithm, much better voting system to politicians, it's hard, because those people who are there in power, they are protecting their seats, and they do not want changes. But what has happened? It has happened that approximately 2 years ago, I was presenting a D21 in New York and Washington, D.C., and representatives of the World Bank suggested that D21 could be a very good tool for participatory budgeting, voting in cities. Participatory budgeting is that people, citizens, make decisions about part of the budget by voting. The first appeared in Brazil, I think, 14 or 15 years ago. Now, New York City is the largest or the most significant city in North America who actively uses participatory budgeting, and New York City has become our client, in fact. So this year, PB has been in New York City using D21. Which we are very proud of, the motivation is that people participate, people are engaged, they are motivating. It is a tool for in the 21st century. Well, now we have democracy, we want to protect democracy, we believe that equal voting rights is a necessary thing for human society to evolve, to be just and fair, to satisfy basic principles. Well, but in modern times, why should we vote only once per 4 or 5 years? We can vote online. We can do it all the time. And I will show you in a moment applications where we have actually evolved already. So in New York City, this year, there were 28 districts out of 52 voting. 67,000 voters, so it has been growing. We believe that the growth will continue for next year and that we will be partners as well. We have designed a digital solution, the software. We provided all the services for New York City and also scanning of ballots. So part of the voting, not all voting, it's not done electronically. In fact, most of voting in New York City has still done on papers. D21 brings is really changes, improvements, engagement of people, and this park I put it here because this Prospect Park is a place where we were there with my colleagues. We went jogging there, so it's a nice place. And the voting of D21 of participatory budgeting improved or changed, caused some investments in the park. So. That's nice, and she is a speaker of the New York Council, very supportive woman. Another I'd like to show you from what I would say the most advanced example, which is now in the Czech Republic. D21, in this participatory budgeting application, has been already quite a few countries, including US, but also Portugal, Tunisia. But the most active we have been, of course, in the Czech Republic. And our, I'd say, star or a great example is the city Říčany, which has 15,000 inhabitants, out of which already over 1,500 are registered in so-called unmanaged Říčany. What does it mean? It means that everybody goes one, there is a fixed cost. The fixed cost that one, you need to take your ID and you need to go to a computer or to a city place, register, you get a code. And then that's it. And once after you have registered, you can always in the future, whenever the city needs to get some information or needs to offer wants your participation, you just get a text message and you can vote and you can make your decisions. You can vote several times a month. In managed Říčany, already over 10 votes has been done in the last year, including serious things like spending public money, but also things like what band they should invite for music festivals. So here, why is it so important? Well, the crucial thing is that we get the information. We open the information highway between city council and the citizens. It happens, and in fact, the mayor of Říčany himself was surprised. They offered a digital ballot for projects that people should vote on, and he had his favorite project, which he thought was great. And in the end, he actually found out that what he thought was a great project, people did not want at all, which was not good news for him. But nevertheless, it is important that you indeed get the objective data. It's not about what you as a city member think. It is really what people want. And not only that, you get a major information set because you know this project. People that like it are men, women, where they live, which part of the city, what's their education, what's their job. You get all these data, as you can see on the map with those squares, so you get all data for each square. And also, not only that, you also have the minus votes, which are very important. So you see what people do not like. You can do so-called strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, threats analysis. You can see for a given project, which has a lot of support, but also a lot of minus votes, that is very controversial. And you can look, who are the people that do not like this project? Which are they like? Well, those are people from this area, those are people with this education, so why is that? Well, and we can improve the project. So this is a great tool. It's not only about voting, but it is the information highway that you get the information and you can subsequently improve on what you are doing. So amazing management tool. For cities, we have done already we have used D21 in over 20 cities in the Czech Republic and other countries as well. But not only in the cities, it can be done also for companies and schools. We have already done voting in several schools for school project, voting with children and also teachers, and also in a few companies. Decision 2.1. Now it's not democracy 2.1, but it is a modern company. How does a company of now should look like or does look like? What's the goal of the company? The goal is create values, create something useful for society to support the society. Of course, it is also profit. Anything that we do must be sustainable, but the profit is not; it should not be the sole goal. And well, in fact, it turns out, interestingly, that if you enlarge your scope to satisfy not only stakeholders, shareholders, but also stakeholders, then actually the profit comes as well. And broader goals, D21 is indeed an amazing tool. Modern management, what will people who are leading the society do? Is it one guy, a dictator, who says, no, it will be this way and doesn't listen to anybody? not very efficient, even though some people do it like that, and some people think, yeah, I won't get into political issues, but there are some approaches. It might work, but it's not really good. I believe that it is much better for a management to use a tool to find out what employees want, what they think, what they would prefer. And the good tool is version 2.1 is indeed democracy 2.1. Not just everybody saying yes or not, but giving people a portfolio of options, seeing what they choose yes and what they choose no. That's the data that we need. It's management employees. It's also management and business partners. We have tested D21 in one company for the sellers, for the distributors. It is also management or company clients. You can find out what clients really need and how you can improve your products. Yeah. Reaching better sustainability, that's the goal of today. We want that. We want to do things that are not against people, that are not too controversial, that are not hurting anybody. We want to find out what people really think and what people really want. And of course, effectiveness is a major issue. We can find out in production, how do you know what are the weaknesses? It happens that it's just the information still is very inefficient. People who are doing the production, the information before it gets from bottom to the top management, it gets lost all the way. So it is very wise to design a tool, to design a questionnaire, but a smart questionnaire, D21 questionnaire, which gives you the weaknesses to find out what really people do not want. I would like to thank you very much, and let me say once more my hope and I believe so, that D21 is becoming and will be a major tool to improve further growth, improve sustainability, and help us to come to the great vision of our society, which I believe really is due. The time is on. And it is not the case that we have already won. I believe we have more than 95% chance of reaching a new chapter of human evolution. There are risks, and the risks are corruption as a cancer, environment, risks in the environment, but I believe we have tools to overcome all these issues, and we will manage to do so. Thank you.